The new dynamic FPS event, whose official name I forget, so I'm calling it Siege of Orison, has been up in the PTU for players to test, and so, naturally, I loaded up and jumped on a shuttle to see if it's worth the time.
Quantum travel initiated.
First off, I'm going to avoid going into full detail of the event, as you really should play it yourself. Which I guess goes to say, spoiler alert, it's great, though not without its issues. The premise is fairly simple. Ninetales have taken over some platforms on the outskirts of Orison, and so Crusader have employed the Civilian Defense Force to come in and take them back. Flying in is a no-go due to airspace restrictions. You will get blown up. So you've no choice but to jump on a shuttle from the showroom roof and fight your way through with good old-fashioned bullets. On each platform, you'll need to face down hordes of enemies, find the lieutenant, get his code, and shut down the AA so you can move on to the next one. First, let's cover the good things. These platforms are amazingly designed and really do show just how good CIG is getting at designing areas. Each one's unique too, so no getting bored of doing the same bunker for the 10th time in a row. Second is that the platforms are very far away from Orison proper, meaning you don't suffer anywhere near as much of an FPS drop as you normally would. Moving around the platforms, you'll find that cover is well placed, and done so in such a way that you're never forced into a meat grinder. Wanna go tactical like I did? You can. Wanna run around with a shotgun like a Muppet? You can do that too. There's plenty of loot to be had too, with the unique Ninetales armor and clothes, as well as basically every weapon you can think of that isn't anti-vehicle. On a gameplay front, there are little markers now above players' heads as well if they're on the same mission, which is a great addition to see, especially if jumping in with randoms like I did. Now unfortunately these markers aren't placed above friendly NPCs' heads. Whether or not CIG can do this before live I don't know, but it would be nice to see. Now, the bad stuff. I'm not going to mention any of the bugs or AI issues here because it's PTU. Let's give them a chance to iron those out. The biggest annoyance for me was the excessive strictness on friendly fire. A single bullet of mine hit a friendly who decided it was a really smart idea to run between my muzzle and the enemy's head that I was in the midst of using as target practice, meaning I was instantly kicked off the mission and given a crime stat level 2. This needs to be reined in, especially as you have no control over other players or the AI. Trigger discipline only goes so far. Also, there's the excessive wait times. Whilst I was clearing my crime stat, the other players cleared the first platform. I had to then wait several minutes for the shuttle to the second platform, meaning I missed quite a lot. I also had the same issue with waiting for ships to respawn so that I could reach the final platform. This is honestly really unnecessary. Something that sadly cannot be realistically fixed before live is that despite how well the areas have been designed, they lack any real direction. Now over time, players will learn where they are going of course, but it punishes those who are new to the event. Subtle cues within the surrounding area would be a great thing to add here. You know, something that doesn't hold your hand, but nudges you in the right direction. So, all in all, this is honestly a great event, especially if, like me, you've been itching for more open engagements than the bunkers afford. Hopefully the bugs and my two big gripes can be rectified before live, and if so, this will be a really good event. Leave your thoughts down below, and with that I thank you for watching, I'll catch y'all next time.